Hello friends, international financial management is a well-known term in today's world and it is also known as international finance. It means financial management in an international business environment. It is different because of the different currency of different countries, dissimilar political situation, imperfect markets, diversified opportunity sets. International financial management came into being when the countries of the world started opening their doors for each other. This phenomenon is well known by the name of liberalization. Due to open environment and freedom to conduct business in any corner of the world, entrepreneurs started looking for opportunities even outside their country boundaries. The spark of liberalization was further aided by swift progression in telecommunications and transportation technologies that too with increased accessibility and daily dropping prices. Apart from everything else, we cannot forget the contribution of financial innovations such as currency derivatives, cross-border stock listings, multi-currency bonds and international mutual funds. The resultant of liberalization and technology advancement is today's dynamic international business environment. Financial management for a domestic business and an international business is as dramatically different as the opportunities in the two. The meaning and objective of financial management do not change in international financial management, but the dimensions and dynamics change drastically. A sound management of international finances can help an organization achieve same efficiency and effectiveness in all the markets. Thus, to understand international finance, it is important to learn about foreign exchange markets, also called as forex markets. For this purpose, in today's session, we will learn about the basics of foreign exchange markets, settlement and communication in it, and the participants of the market. Okay, so let me start with foreign exchange market. A foreign exchange market is a market in which currencies are bought and sold. It is to be distinguished from a financial market where currencies are borrowed and lent. Now, let us talk about general features of foreign exchange market. Foreign exchange market is described as an OTC, that is over-the-counter market, as there is no physical place where the participants meet to execute their deals. It is more an informal arrangement among the banks and brokers operating in a financing center, purchasing and selling currencies connected to each other by telecommunications like telex, telephone and a satellite communication network called SWIFT. The term foreign exchange market is used to refer to the wholesale segment of the market where the dealings take place among the banks. The retail segment refers to the dealings taking place between banks and their customers. The retail segment is situated at a large number of places. They can be considered not as foreign exchange markets but as the counters of such markets. The leading foreign exchange markets in India are Mumbai, Calcutta, Chennai and Delhi. The policy of Reserve Bank has been to decentralize exchanges operations and develop broader based exchange markets. As a result of the efforts of Reserve Bank, Cochin, Bangalore, Ahmedabad and Goa have emerged as new centers of foreign exchange market. Now, let me talk about size of the market. Foreign exchange market is the largest financial market with a daily turnover of over USD 2 trillion. Foreign exchange markets were primarily developed to facilitate settlement of debts arising out of international trade. But these markets have developed on their own so much so that a turnover of about 3 days in the foreign exchange market is equivalent to the magnitude of world trade in goods and services. The largest foreign exchange market is London, followed by New York, Tokyo, Zurich and Frankfurt. The business in foreign exchange market in India has shown a steady increase as a consequence of increase in the volume of foreign trade of the country, improvement in the communication system, and greater access to the international exchange markets. Still, the volume of transactions in these markets amounting to about USD 2 billion per day does not compete favorably with any well-developed foreign exchange market of international repute. The reasons are not far to seek. Rupee is not an internationally traded currency and is not in great demand. Much of the external trade of the country is designated in leading currencies of the world, vis-a-vis US dollar, pound sterling, euro, Japanese yen and Swiss franc. Incidentally, these are the currencies that are traded actively in the foreign exchange market in India. Now, talking about 24-hour market. The markets are situated throughout the different time zone of the globe in such a way that when one market is closing, the other is beginning its operations. Thus, at any point of time, one market or the other is open. Therefore, it is stated that foreign exchange market is functioning throughout 24 hours of the day. However, a specific market will function only during the business hours. Some of the banks having international network and having centralized control of funds management may keep their foreign exchange department in the key center open throughout to keep up with developments at other centers during their normal working hours. In India, the market is open for the time the banks are open for their regular banking business. No transaction take place on Saturdays. Let me now talk about efficiency. Developments in communication have largely contributed to the efficiency of the market. The participants keep abreast of current happenings by access to such services like Dow Jones, Telerit and Tutor. Any significant development in any market is almost instantaneously received by the other market situated at a far off place and thus has a global impact. This makes the foreign exchange market very efficient as if it is functioning under one roof. Let me talk about currencies traded. In most markets, US dollar is the vehicle currency, that is, the currency used to denominate international transactions. This is despite the fact that with currencies like euro and yen gaining larger share, the share of US dollar in the total turnover is shrinking. Talking about physical markets, in few centers like Paris and Brussels, foreign exchange business take place at a fixed place, such as the local stock exchange buildings. At these physical markets, the banks meet and in the presence of the representatives of the central banks and on the basis of bargains, fix rates for a number of major currencies. This practice is called fixing. The rates thus fixed are used to execute customers' orders previously placed with the banks. An advantage claimed for this procedure is that exchange rate for commercial transactions will be market determined, not influenced by any one bank. However, it is observed that the large banks attending such meetings with large commercial orders backing up tend to influence the rates. Talking about the participants. The participants in the foreign exchange market comprise 1. Corporates, 2. Commercial banks, 3. Exchange brokers and 4. Central bank. Now, let me discuss corporates. The business houses, international investors and multinational corporations may operate in the market to meet their genuine trade or investment requirements. They may also buy or sell currencies with a view to speculate or trade in currencies to the extent permitted by the exchange control regulations. They operate by placing orders with the commercial banks. The deals between banks and their clients form the retail segment of foreign exchange market. In India, the foreign exchange management, possession and retention of foreign currency regulation 2000 permits retention by resident of foreign currency up to USD 2000. Foreign currency management, that is realization, repatriation and surrender of foreign exchange regulations 2000 requires a resident in India who receives foreign exchange to surrender it to an authorized dealer. A. Within 7 days of receipt in case of receipt by way of remuneration, settlement of lawful obligations, income on assets held abroad, inheritance, settlement or gift, and within 90 days in all other cases. Now, any person who acquires foreign exchange but could not use it for the purpose or for any other permitted purpose is required to surrender the unutilized foreign exchange to authorized dealers within 60 days from the date of acquisition. In case the foreign exchange was acquired for travel abroad, the unspent foreign exchange should be surrendered within 90 days from the date of return to India when the foreign exchange is in the form of foreign currency notes and coins, and within 180 days in case of traveler's check. Similarly, if a resident requires foreign exchange for an approved purpose, he should obtain from an authorized dealer. Okay, so now about the next participants, that is commercial banks. They are the major players in the market. They buy and sell currencies for their clients. They may also operate on their own. When a bank enters a market to correct excess of sale or purchase position in a foreign currency arising from its various deals with its customers, it is said to do a cover operation. Such transactions constitute hardly 5% of the total transactions done by a large bank. A major portion of the volume is accounted by trading in currencies indulged by the bank to gain from exchange movements. For transactions involving large volumes, bank may deal directly among themselves. For smaller transactions, the intermediation of foreign exchange brokers may be sought. Exchange brokers. They facilitate deal between banks. In the absence of exchange brokers, banks have to contact each other for quotes. If there are 150 banks at a center, for obtaining the best quote for a single currency, a dealer may have to contact 149 banks. Exchange broker ensure that the most favorable quotation is obtained and at low cost in terms of time and money. The bank may leave with the broker the limit up to which and the rate at which it wishes to buy or sell the foreign currency concerned. From the intents from other banks, the broker will be able to match the requirements of both. The names of the counterparties are revealed to the banks only when the deal is acceptable to them. Till then, anonymity is maintained. Exchange brokers tend to specialize in certain exotic currencies, but they also handle all major currencies. In India, banks may deal directly or through recognized exchange brokers. Accredited exchange brokers are permitted to contract exchange business on behalf of authorized dealers in foreign exchange only upon the understanding that they will conform to the rates, rules and conditions laid down by the FDI. All contracts must bear the clause subject to the rules and regulations of the Foreign Exchange Dealers Association of India. Central bank may intervene in the market to influence the exchange rate and change it from that would result only from private supplies and demands. The central bank may transact in the market on its own for the above mentioned reason, or it may do so on behalf of the government when it buys or sells bonds and settles other transactions which may involve foreign exchange payments and receipts. In India, authorized dealers have recourse to Reserve Bank to sell or buy US dollars to the extent the latter is prepared to transact in the currency at the given point of time. Reserve Bank will not ordinarily buy or sell any other currency from or to authorized dealers. The contract can be entered into on any working day of the dealing room of Reserve Bank. No transactions is entered into on Saturdays. The value date for spot as well as forward delivery should be in conformity with the national and international practice in this regard. Reserve Bank of India does not enter into the market in the ordinary course, where the exchange rates are moving in a detrimental way due to speculative forces, the Reserve Bank may intervene in the market either directly or through the State Bank of India. Now, let us discuss the settlement of transactions. Foreign exchange markets make extensive use of the latest developments in telecommunications for transmitting as well as settling foreign exchange transactions. Banks use the exclusive network called SWIFT to communicate messages and settle the transaction at electronic clearing houses such as CHIPS at New York. Now, talking about SWIFT. SWIFT is an acronym for Society for Worldwide Interbank Financial Telecommunications, a cooperative society owned by about 250 banks in Europe and North America and registered as a cooperative society in Brussels, Belgium. It is a communication network for international financial market transactions, linking effectively more than 25,000 financial institutions throughout the world who have been allotted bank identified codes. The messages are transmitted from country to country via central interconnected operating centers located in Brussels, Amsterdam, and Culpeper, Virginia. The member countries are connected to the center through regional processors in each country. The local banks in each country reach the regional processors through the national networks. The SWIFT system enables the member banks to transact among themselves quickly. International payments, statements, other messages connected with international banking. Transmission of messages take place within seconds, and therefore, this method is economical as well as time-saving. Selected banks in India have become members of SWIFT. The regional processing center is situated at Mumbai. The SWIFT provides following advantages for the local banking community. First, it provides a reliable, that is time-tested method of sending and receiving messages from a vast number of banks in a large number of locations around the world. Second, reliability and accuracy is further enhanced by the built-in authentication facilities, which has only to be exchanged with each counterparty before they can be activated or further communications. Third, message relay is instantaneous, enabling the counterparty to respond immediately if not prevented by time differences. Fourth, access is available to a vast number of banks global for launching new cross-border initiatives. Since communication in SWIFT is to be done using structured formats for various types of banking transactions, the matter to be conveyed will be very clear and there will not be any ambiguity of any sort for the received to revert for clarifications. This is mainly because the formats are used all over the world on a standardized basis for conducting all types of banking transactions. This makes the responses and execution very efficient at the receiving bank's end, thereby contributing immensely to the quality service being provided to the customers of both banks, that is sending and receiving. Usage of SWIFT structure formats for message transmission to counterparties will entail the generation of local banks' internal records using at least minimum level of automation. This will accelerate the local banks' internal automation activities since the maximum utilization of SWIFT, a significant internal automation level, is required. Now, talking about CHIPS. CHIPS stands for Clearing House Interbank Payment System. It is an electronic payment system owned by 12 private commercial banks constituting New York Clearing House Association. A CHIP began its operation in 1971 and has grown to be the world's largest payment system. Foreign exchange and Eurodollar transactions are settled through CHIPS. It provides the mechanism for settlement every day of payment and receipts of numerous dollar transactions among member banks at New York without the need for physical exchange of checks or fund for each such transactions. The functioning of CHIPS arrangement is explained below with a hypothetical transaction. Bank of India maintaining a dollar account with MX Bank, New York sells USD 1 million. To Canara Bank maintaining dollar account with Citibank. Now, first one. Bank of India intimates MX Bank to debit the account of bank through SWIFT and transfer USD 1 million to Citibank for credit of current account of Canara Bank. Second, MX Bank debits the account of Bank of India with USD 1 million and sends the equivalent of electronic checks to CHIPS for crediting the account of Citibank. The transfer is effected the same day. Third, numerous such transactions are reported to CHIPS by member banks and transfer effected at CHIPS. By about 4:30 p.m. that is Eastern time, the net position of each member is arrived at and funds made available at Fedwire for use by the bank concerned by 6 p.m. Eastern time. Fourth, Citibank which receives the credit intimates Canara Bank through SWIFT. It may be noted that the settlement of transactions in the New York Foreign Exchange Market takes place in two stages. First, clearance at CHIPS and arriving at the net position for each bank, and second, transfer of Fed funds for the net position. The real balances are held by banks only with Federal Reserve banks, that is Fed funds, and the transaction is complete only when Fed funds are transferred. Reconciliation and reducing the number of entries that pass through Fed wire. Let us now discuss CHEPS. It is an arrangement similar to CHIPS that exists in London. CHEPS stands for Clearing House Automated Payment System. Lastly, we'll talk about Fed wire. The transaction at New York Foreign Exchange Market ultimately gets settled through Fed wire. It is a communication network that links the computers of about 7,000 banks to the computers of Federal Reserve banks. The Fedwire funds transfer system operated by the Federal Reserve Bank are used primarily for domestic payments, bank-to-bank and third-party transfers such as interbank overnight funds, sales and purchase, and settlement transactions. Corporate to corporate payments can also be made, but they should be effected through banks. Fed guarantees settlement on all payments sent to receivers, even if the sender fails. Okay, so let us summarize today's session. International finance has become an important wing for all big multinational companies. Without the expertise in international financial management, it can be difficult to sustain in the market, because international financial markets have a totally different shape and analytics compared to the domestic financial markets. Thus, in this session, we tried understanding the basics of Forex market by understanding its basic features, the settlement mechanisms through CHIPS, CHEPS and Fedwire, communication through SWIFT mechanism, and also the participants in the market, which includes corporate, commercial banks, exchange brokers, and central banks. I hope this session was of great use to you in understanding international financial management. Thank you.